pretty very friendly. Our culture a little bit conservative, but inside our community, we always like a restaurant to get.
When you drink, you use like turn away your head a little bit.
True, that look at you.
Well, you took me to another level of Korean experience.
韩国当地产的这个辛拉面，泡菜。
Centering of Korea.
Very lovely community.
Before it's kind of poor area.
Wow, 这也太美了.
Welcome to Korea.
Okay, 刚怎么样？
2023年12月5日，我结束在日本的行程，飞到了韩国，我的第122国。
我现在见到了治国。
我和治国初次相识于2021年年末的尼加拉瓜，后来又多次在哥斯达黎加、哥伦比亚、美国遇到。他这次专程从老家韩国大邱到釜山来接我。
大家好，
各位
帅哥、美女，这个地方叫釜山、，but actually we are outside 釜山。Anyway, you must be hungry. We eat something. We will take you very special local restaurant. Welcome, brother.
谢谢。直播带我来的这家餐厅没有这个，外面没有任何的标牌。
刚
怎么样？
这是我第一次吃到这么传统当地的韩国菜，我也觉得真的非常开心，非常幸运。
You know, like, now the season, like for every like a Korean house, they do make 泡菜.
In my hometown, we have something similar, like a 榨菜.
Do you mean like somebody asked me to cook this type of food? I cannot. Too many. It took a lot of time.I really appreciate the people who cook like food.
China, Korea, in general, similar culture, but on the table, when you are eating, something are different. Like what I say, normally people, they don't coat up the bowl.
Most people, they don't care about the onion, like older people.
In my hometown, some people eat that.
In Japan and China, not much time, I remember, you know, to use a spoon. But in Korea, only spoon and chopstick together.
Yeah, true. A spoon for the rice.
It's easy, yeah.
Oh,
太棒了。饭后，智国，他说送过我一个礼物，这是在整个韩国都可以用的一张交通卡，不光是在釜山，在首尔也可以使用。
This gift for you.
OK. 就是任何的便利店都可以充值，然后在韩国使用智能交通卡。
Use it in Seoul.
We share the price.
No. Next time.
我那边订了一个住的地方，本来我们说一人一半，智国非得要把这整个钱全给我，然后我说那非得这样，那就之后用这个钱来这个来付吃的吧。
I'll keep half for our food.
其实我也有我的礼物给治国，是我自己的这个 CD。
Thank you very much. Oh wow, it's the portal.
Yeah. My CD.
生活，
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 对。志国说，韩国这边的公交车是下车之后30分钟内要转另一趟车，30分钟之内都是免费的，不光是在釜山，整个韩国都是。这30分钟之内转车免费的，不光只有巴士，也可以免费转乘地铁。咖啡。
欢
送你的欢送在韩国基本上地铁里的 WiFi 都是免费可以直接使用的。现在我们在转乘另外一趟车，
然后我们最终到了我们之前订的一家宾馆，
就是酒店住的地方。在韩国呢，就是进房间也是要脱鞋的，这是我们今天住的地方。这地方订了3个晚上，大概花了296人民币，这算是打折扣的价格，很便宜。现在是吃晚饭的时间，我 跟着直播，现在去一家当地餐厅。这个来釜山之前，志国做了好多的这个搜索这边的比较地道的小吃，比较地道的餐厅。到餐厅的第一件事，喝茶。So this is really like typical Korean local restaurant. First time ever, I really feel like very unique with Korean food. It's not only spicy chicken noodle, not only kimchi. For two of us to eat all of this, like 100 yuan.
Okay. For me.
Oh, the second one I'm pour for you. It's a culture here.
Yeah.
Okay.
Gombe. Gombe.
Gombe.
Gombe. Gombe. Gombe. Yeah, like this. Another one here, like this. Yeah, like this. When you drink, you start turning away your head a little bit.
I didn't know it's like so local in the Korean.
Please experience whatever you want for this. We welcome you with all our hearts. Try to be very friendly. Our culture maybe a little conservative, but inside our culture, we always like to welcome the guests and we try to be friendly. But you know, I told you before, like some people, you know, who cannot speak, you know, like a foreign language, is kind of shy and like try to keep some distance. That's because of the language. We have like many Thai dishes, like that's why the Korean people drink a lot.
志国说这里边吃的除这两个主要的，其他的都是免费无限次续加的豆芽酱豆，然后这是韭菜吧，然后泡菜、海带。哇，
It's
wow.
really nice. It's the sauce.
I love this one. Oh, you took me to another level of the Korean experience. That food is so tasty. Oh, 现在我们在另外一个地方，这个烧烤的地方。Yeah, yeah. 吃过，想让我尝这个活章鱼。Not at this moment, because I'm pretty full. Like, I'm gonna vomit after this one.
Okay,
yeah.
Okay.
现在刚刚回到住的地方，在这个住的地方这个宾馆里呢，它是这个地暖，跟中国的北方很像。
啊，
中国的北方。我家里就有这种地暖。志国说那个韩国的这个啤酒呢，可能呢
很差。
差不差我不敢说，但是呢这烧酒真的是impressive， 这个我跟志国一块喝的这个烧酒的这个瓶子带回去我收藏了，这也是在韩国喝的这第一瓶酒，收藏做以后的回忆，放在家里。第二天早上，这是这个酒店里的自助早餐，这有这个泡面，可以这个自己泡。
We eat ramen this way.
Oh.
然后这个面弄成了两半儿，韩国当地产的这个辛拉面，然后泡菜。
How the Korean economy grew so fast, like in '80s, right?
I think in Korea, we are diligent. I think in some way smart. Their president, like, is really great. She went to many countries to borrow money. He went so many countries, even to the Philippines. And he invest that money to some industry.
Their economy is based on the producing industry.
Yes.There's nothing, so we have to make something out of nothing. So like they imported this ingredient, but they remake.
I think K-pop in the originally maybe they also got some idea from other country. And but they made it in a very...
It's kind of Korean.
Yeah.
So I think it's Korean people like, we are doing something.Maybe we should be the first, the forced to do that. We are supposed to, like, to be number one, and kind of like a spirit. Maybe like, I would say Korean spirit. When you do something, we have to be first. Even to start late, but in the end, you have to be first in that area. So we work so hard. My mom's age, they work really hard.
I think it's going like the age of my last generation. Like I think China was a little bit later than.
It's a very lovely community for living. This place. Especially in the such.
Before it's not a poor area.
Oh.
Some people say it's, you know, the Greece, Santorini. Santorini of Korea. Korea Santorini.
这介绍的是发这个指尖这个上面写的是大概就是希望你去教堂这边宗教方面治国跟我说有一半可能就是没有就是一个那种宗教信仰另外一半呢有一半是佛教还有一半是这个基督教这在这边还是挺多挺常见的然后这是一个普通的便利店药店这边也可以扫码然后支付宝可以扫码支付在这边。然后我们到了这个地方，叫做甘村，釜山的一个数一数二的一个游客胜地，就非常漂亮的这个各种各样的彩色的房子。Yes， 在这边的话，基本上都有这个中文的这个标识，甘川的由来。How do you say the toilet in Korea?
化妆间。
It's a 化妆间，化妆间。Yeah.
化妆间。
就是排队跟小王子拍照。这个地方50年代的时候，就是非常贫困的一个区域，但是后来60、70年代他们开始改造，现在变成这个样子。哇，这也太美了！
釜山的甘村也是我之前从未想过在韩国看到的景色，如今它也是回顾韩国历史发展的一个地方。然后在甘村之后，志国带我去了一家许多年前他就曾到过的排队人很多的当地的餐厅。
志国点的那个釜山特色的这个当地的酒。
在韩国，当地的米酒和烧酒的价格类似于中国啤酒的价格，这也是我很喜欢当地的一点。
这个地方是釜山的叫步行街，每年釜山电影节的时候， 这边都会有很多人聚在这里。
2017 October.
You know him?
Oh, see, also the Hong Kong.
Yeah.
Also,
yeah.
Who is
he?
I think it's Chinese.
Oh.
治国在釜山陪了我三天，之后从釜山坐火车前往了首尔。这些年来，我几乎在每个国家都会有当地朋友的陪伴。认识这些朋友的方式有很多，大部分是通过 Couchsurfing 等网站，但我认识治国的方式则是另外一种。我们最初是在中美洲的一家青年旅社认识的，这也是我们认识各地朋友的另一个方式之一。很多人经常问我有没有我最喜欢的国家，我的答案差不多一直都是我爱每一个国家，因为我相信每一个地方都有值得每个人爱的地方，而认识当地的人也是打开每个地方的方式之一。
这是韩国的寺庙，这个叫东庙，这是第一次来到这边韩国当地的寺庙。所以我刚一看这个感觉还挺熟悉的，这个面孔也是关公。
关于韩国的物价，基本上感觉都比中国的物价贵一倍，除了米酒和烧酒比中国便宜一倍。住宿出行都可以用中国的各大 APP 来解决。关于韩国签证，这个签证花了大约500人民币，是电子签证，但是要交护照原材料。我提交了许多年前拿到的美国签证，免去了台历证明。韩国电子签证可以在当地停留90天。关于我对韩国的整体印象，它真的和中国东部沿海的城市非常的像，从街头标识到交通设计，除了语言和文字。关于韩国当地的文化，我知道因为某些原因，在中国总是有很多关于韩国的这样那样的读解，但是如果你是真的希望去看，去了解我们这个世界，我相信你会有自己的思考。每一个所谓的国家都是我们这片美丽世界的组成部分，哪里都有热情好客的人们和你的新朋友。我这次在韩国待了9天的时间，之后从首尔飞了中国香港，因为搜到了便宜的机票，这张机票花了402人民币。后来又在2023年结束之前，到了中国这片土地上我最后一个还没有到过的省份海南。之后我第二次去了马来西亚和泰国。我的2023年的最后的一段的行程大概就是这样。在视频的最后，祝大家每个人在2024年的行程当中顺利平安，去到你们想去的每一个地方，没有人可以阻挡你，除了你自己。